Good morning. I am P. Vijayalakshmi, Assistant Professor in the Department of Mechanical Engineering in Tandai Periyar Government Institute of Technology, Vellore. Today we are going to discuss about steering system. So, before venturing into the layout of the steering system, so what is a steering system? The steering system comprises of the mechanism which causes the wheel to turn about the kingpin axis in the stub axle. So this is the kingpin and this is the stub axle. So with this as the axis, the wheel turns. Usually the wheel turns about 20 to 40 degrees. So the layout of the steering system will depend upon the type of suspension. There are two types of suspension. One is rigid axle suspension, where you have a leaf spring for both the, this is the rear axle, this is the front axle. So you can see both are being connected by a rigid front axle. So this is a rigid axle suspension where you use leaf springs for suspension. So the other one is independent suspension system, where the movement of one wheel will not affect the movement of the another wheel. So such type of suspensions are called as independent suspension. So in the layout of the steering system, you can see it starts with the steering wheel near the driver, and then you can see the steering column. So these steering column etc. goes inside the dashboard. So we won't be able to see. So steering wheel, and then you can see the steering column, and you have a steering box. So this box is being used to reduce the motion, or to, in other case, to reduce the velocity. So even if the driver steers the wheel by two turns, the wheel will not proportionally turn two turns. It will just turn 20 degree or 20 degrees only. So to reduce this motion, there is a steering gearbox present. So its function is, one is to reduce the motion, or to say the reduce the velocity. The other one is to increase the torque. So if the driver has to turn a wheel, he has to exert a large amount of torque. To reduce that torque that has to be applied by the driver, the steering gearbox comes into play. So from the steering gearbox, here you can see the cross arm or cross shaft. So the steering gearbox outcome comes through the cross shaft. From the cross shaft, the cross shaft connects with the drop arm, or sometimes it is called as the pitman arm. So the pitman arm is connected to the drag link. So if this is going to, cross shaft will rotate. So when the cross shaft is rotating, automatically the drop arm will oscillate. So it will move this way and this way. So it is going to oscillate. So when it oscillates, it pulls and pushes the drag link. So when this is being pushed and pulled, and through the link rod, the stub axle is also being turned. So if it is moving like this, it will move like this, or it will move like this. So this is how the steering system works. So steering wheels, rotation, it enters gearbox, steering gearbox, output is through cross shaft, which also rotates. It is connected to the drop arm, which oscillates, and here you have the link rod, which is also going to oscillate. So the link rod is connected to the stub axle. So the stub axle will turn about the kingpin, which is located in the center. So the movement of the one wheel is being transmitted to the other wheel with the help of the track rod, and this portion is called as track rod arm, and this is the tie rod or tack rod. Through ball and socket joint, the other wheel also turns. So this is how the steering system works in the case of a rigid axle suspension. Now let us consider the case of an independent suspension system, where this particular example uses wishbone suspension. See, here again, we have the steering wheel, steering column, steering gearbox, cross shaft, drop arm, and from that you have the relay rod. So this rod relays the motion to both the stub axles through a tie rod. So this rod is called as tie rod. And for the purpose of balancing, you have one more idler arm which is fixed to the frame. Okay. So this is how the independent suspension system has the steering system. So we discussed there are various types of gearboxes. So we will see what are the various types of gearboxes are available. So as discussed earlier, steering gearboxes are used to multiply the torque applied by the driver and to reduce the motion. So basic type is worm and wheel steering gearbox. So here you have the steering column. On the steering column, teeth are cut which constitutes the worm portion. So when the steering wheel is rotated, the worm also will rotate. So the teeth on the worm meshes with the wheel, a sector of the wheel. So when this rotates, since this is in mesh with the worm, this oscillates. And this oscillation causes the crosshaft in the middle to rotate. It will move like this. So this cross arm is connected to the drop arm, and this drop arm is connected to the drag link, and that causes the stub axle to move. So this is the steering gearbox with worm and worm wheel. So the next type of steering gearbox is worm and nut. So here again, the steering wheel or the steering column has worm cut on it, so you can see the worm. And instead of a wheel sector, so this is just like a screw. So when the screw rotates, automatically the nut will reciprocate. So this nut reciprocate is connected to the cross shaft, so that also will reciprocate. That turns, so the cross shaft turns, it turns in this way, and that causes the drop arm to oscillate. So this is worm and nut steering gearbox. So one of the important things that we have to take care in the case of steering gearboxes is that even though the motion of the steering wheel is to be transmitted to the rod wheels, the motion of the rod wheels should not be transmitted to the steering wheels. So all those that is called as reversibility. So to prevent reversibilities, various arrangements will be provided in the steering gearboxes. And the next type is reciprocating ball. So this is also similar to the worm and nut. So instead of having worm or teeth cut on it, you have the screw cut on the steering column, and you have a nut. So this nut has an outer casing along which this is the guideways for balls. So this balls will travel along the screw bit, or it will travel in between the screw and the nut. So these are roller balls or round balls which provide free motion, or say to reduce the friction. So when this rotates, as usual, the nut reciprocates. But the nut's outer casing has teeth cut on it. These teeth mesh with the wheel sector. So when the nut reciprocates, the wheel sector oscillates, and that motion is being transmitted to the drop arm through the cross shaft. So the main advantage of this recirculating ball is that it is frictionless. Since the friction is less, it is easy to steer. And here you can also have adjustments to prevent the end play, and the balls further help in free movement of the nut. So the recirculating ball steering gearbox is one of the frequently used steering gearbox. And the next you can see cam and double roller steering gearbox. So the cam and the double roller steering gearbox, as the name suggests, consist of a specially profiled cam which is on the steering column. When the steering column rotates, the roller moves along the cam. So when the cam rotates, the roller oscillates or it travels along the length of the roller. This motion causes the cross shaft to turn. So this turning motion causes the drop arm to oscillate. So this is called as cam and double roller mechanism. So in today's, or say in this lecture, we have discussed about what are the various components of the steering system and how the steering system is being laid out for rigid axle suspension and independent suspension. And then we have discussed about the various types of gearboxes: worm and wheel steering gearbox, worm and nut steering gearbox, recirculating ball steering gearbox, and cam and double roller steering gearbox. So with this, we'll see in the next discussion. Thank you.